Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. I want to welcome you, those who are in the house, those who are watching us from their places, from their homes. We have many followers who are following us all over the world. I want to welcome those who are in America, those who are in Europe, Asia, those who are in Africa, the other countries of these nations. Everywhere where you are, I want to greet you this wonderful day. Praise the Lord. I want to say this is the day the Lord has made. It was wonderful to be in His presence. Yes, in these unique times, I want to say God is at work and God has blessed us. We are stronger than we were last Sunday. We are stronger than we were last Wednesday because God is still working in our lives. God is still working, strengthening us and empowering us and helping us to raise our hands and look at what is ahead of us and even prepare for that which is ahead of us. So, what to thank God for this day and what to thank God for this service. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, those who on the instrument, please make sure that the sound is okay. The sound system is okay. Amen. God bless you. Hallelujah. So we want to thank God for this day and we want to bless the Lord because of His goodness and mercy. We want to welcome all of you so that this day the Lord may minister to us. God has been moving on this altar. And I know today, again, the Lord is going to help us. Today, we're going to have our third series of preparation for the end times. The first series, the other Sunday but one, we were looking at the signs of the end of the age. And we looked at two very important things that has happened. Prophetic events that have already taken place. Then we were here last Sunday. We were talking about Jesus is building His church. And we were saying that we are still in the church age. Somebody has an opportunity to be prepared. Somebody has an opportunity to be recruited in the kingdom of God before Jesus comes. And so, today we want to have the third series because we know now that two great events have taken place. One is the burning of the fig tree, the rebirth of Israel, of the nation of Israel, in April 1948. That was a very unique sign of the end time. Number two was Jews taking over Jerusalem again back in June 1967. That is when, after the nation of Israel was reborn in 1948, the first time they were able to step back in Jerusalem was in June 1967. Why? It was another prophetic sign being fulfilled at the end time. For Jesus had said in the book of Luke, verses 24, that Jerusalem shall be trodden by the Gentiles until the fulfillment of the times of the Gentile. When the children of God were able to conquer Egypt, were able to conquer the nation of Jordan and the nation of Syria, because they said they are going to finish Israel, and for the first day, the Jews entered the holy city in June 1967, then I'm saying that was one sign of the fulfillment of the time of the Gentiles. Another powerful sign of the end time. And then last year I told you, we are still in the church age when Jesus is building His church, is allowing the Gentiles to be ushered, to be recruited in the kingdom of God through the preaching of the gospel and people giving their life to Jesus. So today, brethren, we want to look at two things, two events after the rapture and the judgment seat of God, the Bema seat, of Christ. So that later on Sunday, I've been talking about what details of what will be happening at the bema seat of Christ. Before then, we got to talk about the other things, about tribulations, and the Christ, and even the second coming of the Lord Jesus, and even the millennium, and even eternity. Today, please, in a short while, we just look at two events. One is rapture, and two, standing before the bema seat of Christ for our rewards. Amen. So let's go to our Bibles. Before, let's pray for the word. We want to thank you, Father, because of yet another opportunity to be in your presence on this altar of Jesus in the center and share your word with this church that has no boundaries. The online church, a multitude of people, a community, Lord, that you are building this time, Lord of glory, who are benefiting from the word coming from this altar. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I pray, Father, for all our followers and our viewers, that this day, God of glory, power shall come from your throne. Get to realize, wisdom shall come from your Lord, throne by throne. Into their lives, Lord, you shall equip us and you shall edify us and get us ready for the work of the ministry and perfect even your church for your works, and even Lord of glory, prepare for that which is ahead of us. Abba Father, I pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that you shall be a blessing to all of us. In Jesus' name I pray. I'm reading 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. I'm reading verses 16 and 17, two verses. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, two verses. Verse 16 is saying, for the Lord himself shall be sent from heaven with a shout and with the voice of the archangel and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. 17 says, then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Then allow me to ask some of us in the book of Corinthians. I'm reading 2 Corinthians, and I'll read again 1 Corinthians, just briefly a few verses. I'm reading 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 10. Let's go together. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 10. Then we read 1 Corinthians chapter 3, and then I'll be done. The Bible is saying, 2 Corinthians 5:10, it says, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ. Brethren, that is what we are calling the bema seat. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the things done in his body, according to that he had done, whether it be good or bad. Amen. Then my final verses today is 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 13 and 15. 1 Corinthians 3, verses 13 and 15. That it says, if you are there, every man's work, every man's work shall be made manifest, for the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire, and the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is. Even a man's work abide, which he had built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. Oh my, this is at the bema seat. Even a man's work shall be burnt, he shall suffer loss, but he himself so as by fire. Amen. Brethren, please go with me. My business, by the gift of the Holy Ghost and the ministry God has given me, it is to make that which is tough for you to become very easy, for you to understand. It is to feed on the scriptures and get an understanding from the Holy Ghost and make you to understand. That's why the Bible says in the book of Ephesians 4 that God gave some to be apostles, to be evangelists, to be pastors, to be teachers, for the equipping of the body of Christ, for the work of the ministry, and for edification of the saints, for teaching, for instruction. And this is what we are doing from this altar. So today, I continue with the teaching, and I'm talking about today what we are waiting for. As Jesus continues to prepare his bride, the church, as Jesus continues to sanctify us by washing us with the word of God, so that we become holy, we become pure, we become a bride that has no spot, no wrinkle. Jesus will be preparing us for this great day that is ahead of us. And this is the day of rapture. What are we waiting for? Don't wait for any other prophetic sign. Prophetic signs about the end of time, they are over. They are over. The next thing now in this series, in the next step, is rapture. Rapture will be the next sign of the end time. What we are told in the book of Thessalonians, that the Lord will descend from his Father. That is what we are calling the latter. How? Jesus is going to descend to the heavens. And when he descends, he will come and resurrect those who have died in Christ. And those who shall be in Christ and will not be dead, the Bible is saying, then we shall be changed, and we shall be lifted up by the power of God, and all of us shall hear the trump of God, and then we shall be taken by Jesus to be with him in heaven. That is what we are calling as rapture. And when rapture takes place and we are taken to heaven, the next thing is these believers, this church that Jesus has raptured, hallelujah, will be taken to the bema seat, the throne of God, the throne of God, the bema seat. 2 Corinthians has said, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that we may receive the things done in the body. Please, let me explain here. This is not judgment for punishment. This is not judgment of everybody. It is for the church of Christ. Those people who have accepted the Lord Jesus and they have been in the service of the Lord. They have been serving their master. They have been serving their God. Because the moment you come to Christ, you don't just come to sit. You don't just come to enjoy yourself and relax and say things are okay. Jesus calls us and equips us so that we may serve him. Because when we appear before the bema seat of heaven, that will be the day of promotion. That will be the day when we shall be rewarded for the work we have done. That is the day when what we have done shall be put to test. We shall be called to account for the work we have done. Brethren,
who was serving God, let nothing hinder you, not even the hardship, not even anything, because whatever you are doing has been put in the record of heaven, and you shall be awarded on the day of the Lord when you stand as an individual before the bema seat of Christ in heaven. The Bible is saying in the chapter, First Corinthians 3, is that the work we do shall be put to test and shall be tested with the fire. The Bible is saying that if you somebody's work is going to be burned, he is going to suffer loss. If somebody's work is going to stand, then that person is going to be awarded. That is the day we shall receive those which we call as the five crowns. On Sunday, be here, be on this altar, be connected to the altar. I'll be showing you the five crowns that Jesus will be giving to the individual members of his church because of their faithful service. Hallelujah. Today, as I finish, I want to say this. When we stand before the bema seat of heaven, we shall be called to account for one time, because God gives us a resource called time, so that when we stand before him, we shall be asked how we have used our time. Brethren, remember this resource called time is very important before God, and we're supposed to use our time wisely. You need to have your time, and you need to have time for God. Time for God. Christians are so full of themselves. They have no time for God. God is so organized. Even when he was doing his work, he did it for 6 days. And on the seventh day, he rested. And he also told you to work for 6 days. And so the seventh day, you have a day to worship God. I want to tell you, brother, sister, yes, you can tell me, you give your tithe, you give your money, you also supposed to have your tithe of time. You need to spend good time in the presence of God in your life. You need to spend quality time seeking God, loving God and serving God. Because one day, I and you shall stand before the bema seat of heaven, and we shall be asked to account for the resource of time that God has given to us. When we use our time wisely, we shall get a crown in heaven. Number two, we shall be called to account for the money and the possessions God has given to us. Brother, I know the gospel you've been preached to the church because of lack of knowledge, because of lack of information, because the church is not grounded in the word of truth, the word of God. We hear the preaching of the devil, and we hear the preaching of the world from our friends who do not know God about our money, about our resources, and they hinder us from being faithful in serving God. And one day, whatever money, whatever resource, whatever possession that you have, you shall be called to account for it before God. How you have used it. The Bible says, I remind you in Matthew 6, 19, 21, it says, lay not for yourself treasures upon the earth, where moth and lust doth corrupt, and where these break through and steal, but lay for yourself precious in heaven. Amen. Where neither moth nor rust nor doth corrupt, and where these do not break through and steal. Please invest your money, invest your possessions in the kingdom of God. It matters so much. It is very important, because one day you shall be called to account for all the money and all the resources that God has given to you. Brethren, Church of Christ, wherever you are, wherever you serve, let us serve faithfully. Let us not give like we are giving to a man of God, or we are giving to somebody. Let us not serve God unknowingly, in foolishness, in lack of understanding. Let us be grounded in the word of truth. That is a sign of spiritual maturity. Number three, we shall be called to account for the souls we have brought in the kingdom of God. Oh my, you came to the kingdom of God through the preaching of the gospel. That is the gospel that you had. And when you receive Christ, you become a witness. You become an ambassador of Christ. Yes, that day you will be rewarded for the many souls you have brought to the kingdom. Sister, brother, Church of Christ, let us not slumber. Let us not live ignorantly. It is our business to feed the fishes of men. Because that day we shall be crowned. We shall be given a crown. We shall be rewarded for the many souls we have brought in the kingdom of God. Then lastly, we shall be called to the second last. We shall be called to account for our prayer life. Our prayer life. Hello. Church Christians are living as if there's no enemy. Jesus said, pray. Pray that you may escape the temptation. Pray. He had his church. And they were unable to tarry for 1 hour. He told them, can you tarry with me for 1 hour? They were not even be able to tarry with the Lord Jesus Christ for 1 hour. Even today, the church is slumbering. The church is not praying. Yeah, when talk of a rocket out of church, you imagine it's like you have been telling me to pray. Who said you should not pray? Who said you should not fast? Who should make you not come for Kesha? That is, nobody has said that. They can lock the four corners of the house, but they cannot lock your prayer life. And so you are supposed to be connected to the heavens throughout by prayer, because you have an access of getting in the Holy of Holies and talk to God. You don't need Bishop Migwi. You don't need the other one person. You don't need Father Who. You just need Jesus Christ, who is the mediator between you and God. And go before God. So we shall be called to account for our prayer life. Brethren, wherever you are, this anytime, Jesus is calling you to strengthen yourself and to pray and to seek his faith in the name of the Lord. I'm almost finishing now. The last two I'm saying, the other thing you shall be called to account when you stand before the bema seat of God is you shall be called to account for all the words that you have spoken in your life from when you received Christ. Hear me and hear me well. By your words shall you be judged. The Bible says, Matthew 12, 36, says, but I say unto you that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give an account thereof in the day of judgment. That is the day of recording. All the clearest words you have spoken, all the gossip. The Church of Christ is very busy in gossiping. It's very easy. It's very busy in being busy bodies. Instead of being the important things, they are busy gossiping and talking nonsense. And every time they waste a lot of time talking nothing. And talking lies and talking things which are not even helpful. And that's why there's a lot of confusion in the body of Christ. Can I tell you tonight, this day, you shall be called to account for every word that has come from your mouth after you receive Christ. Because somebody was received Christ, and somebody is supposed to live a disciplined life, an organized life, to know that your words are tools, are weapons, and the words that you speak have a lot of impact in the lives of the other people. So, church, it is time to be disciplined. If you have been abused and misused your mouth, tell the Lord to have mercy on you and to help you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Then lastly, I want to say this, we shall be called to account for the attitudes we have towards other brethren. The attitudes. Jesus, the Bible says, Romans 12:10, that we are supposed to love one another and supposed to honor one another. Is it happening in the body of Christ? In the body of Christ, it's about strength, it's about division, it's about selfishness, it's about hatred, it's about all those nonsense, all those evil things, all those wicked things. And before the bema seat of Christ, we shall be called to account for our attitudes. Do you love your neighbor? Do you love your sister? Do you love your brother? Do you honor that person? Do you love that Now it's you will be called to account for that. My sister, my brother, allow Jesus to prepare you. Jesus are not a rapture, a people who are not well prepared. That's why we are here, to preach the gospel, to teach you the word of truth, so that you can be get yourself ready. By the power of this word, I pray you be sanctified. I pray you be cleansed. By the power of this word, I pray that you organize your life, organize your Christianity, organize your salvation. Do the right things and get yourself ready for rapture, so that after rapture, we go to the bema seat. When you go to the bema seat, we be given the crowns. And then shall you be with the Lord all the time in the name of the Lord. As I finish, are you there? And you have not given your life to Jesus? Reason to me, whatever lies ahead is for them who are in Christ. Jesus is coming for his church. Rapture is coming. Rapture is on the way. I don't know what when. I don't know what time. It's only God who knows. But remember, you're supposed to get ready. This is your day to receive Christ in the name of the Lord. Receive Christ Jesus, and then you'll be able to be raptured. And when you are raptured, you'll be able to escape whatever we call as the Antichrist, the 7 years of tribulation, or death and the famine and the sickness and everything, all evils that will be on this earth, you'll be able to escape that suffering in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. For those who have given their life to Jesus, let COVID-19 be an excuse for you to backslide, for you to go back. It is time to be strong. It is time to stand well. It is time to cross your life. It is time to fear God. It's time to, for you to do that which is right, so that you are ready if Jesus comes tomorrow, then we can be raptured in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the truth from this altar that is supposed to help you, that is supposed to deliver you, that is supposed to set you free in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray for the word in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And as you pray for the word, prepare your tithe and prepare your offering. Those in the house and who are out of the house, oh, remember those who are out of this place, our TO number 677-479. You can use that and connect to this altar and get the blessing, and get the grace, and get the power, and get the wisdom, and get the knowledge from this altar that will keep you and that will deliver you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, our Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I want to thank you because of this word. My God, I pray that this word shall be transformed into life by my full healers. In the name of the Lord, this day Jesus, save every person who shall call upon your name. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and therefore I pray for the seeker from this altar, as many that are hearing this voice and following us, God of glory, may power get to them. Hear them, Lord. Deliver the child. Deliver your people from the COVID-19 and any other pandemic and any other evil. Deliver us, my Father, all from the evil, from the mighty, and from the stronger. In Jesus' name, and keep us, God of glory, and preserve us. And by the power of the Holy Ghost, Lord, I pray, you shall equip and prepare the church and get it ready for rapture. In Jesus' name, we bless your name and we worship you. Thank you, God, as they prepare their tithes and offerings to connect to this altar and to connect to this one. Lord, I pray, the grace of God, the blessings of God, the provision from heaven, the grace of Jehovah shall come upon their lives. Lord, remember them. And Lord, visit them. Lord, visit the child. Lord, visit the people that your blood under my umbrella in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I shook their lives in the blood of the Lord. I declare they are blessed. I declare they are preserved by the power of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All of us say, amen. Please go and treasure this truth, this word. Yeah, people have been taught so much about blessings and prosperity, but not many have been taught the truth you are getting from this altar. Preserve these and keep these. It's going to help you as you go forward. Shalom, shalom, and may the peace of God be upon you. We meet again here on this altar on Wednesday to continue to be blessed of God. In Jesus' name.